Right now, what they're doing is the first priority is life safety. So they're trying to take care of anyone who might be hurt. The second priority will be to secure the scene and begin an investigation to figure out what happened. The third priority, also very high, will be to protect the responders and other people against another attack, if that's what it turns out to be. We have to be very clear. I've been involved in many different kinds of incidents in my career.
You ran counterterrorism for the city of New York.
Yeah,
Richard was the former deputy commissioner of the New York City Police Department.
Yes,
and quite familiar with
it. Did this sort of thing from the White House level as well. First reports are often wrong, and it's very easy to get the wrong sort of general direction of something before all the facts came out. This is truly breaking news. It just happened. And while it has, from what we can see, many of the hallmarks of a terrorist attack, it's far too early to decide that's what it is.
Why do you say it's got the hallmarks of a terrorist attack?
If it's correct, and we need to caveat everything, that there were two explosions and they were separate events, that is an indicator that it isn't just one, like some sort of combustion in a gap in a trash can or a steam pipe that blew up, but two separate simultaneous events is a hallmark.
Sure.
Second, it's a widely attended, highly publicized event. The sort of thing that have been targeted before. You don't know what you don't know yet. Many, many more facts will come out about this. But the responding personnel who are on the ground going in will be thinking the worst until they have reason to relax. And the worst for them is that this is the beginning of a campaign, meaning it's not over. There might be other
events.
So this is what I mentioned before. They have to be very careful themselves about the possibility of secondary devices being used against them. Now, we certainly hope this isn't a terrorist attack.
And by the way, Richard, just to be clear, might that be why so many people have been evacuated, the streets empty? In other words, if there is a subsequent device, were this to be a terrorist event, the police would want to get everyone away.
Absolutely. And that's SOP.
Well, in fact, that's what we're seeing right now. WBZ reporting that the Copley Square Hotel is on lockdown following these explosions. So they're certainly doing everything they can to either get people out of the way or potentially putting it on lockdown, I imagine, checking to see who's actually still there.
Right. And they're both trying to make sure no one else becomes a victim, but they're also thinking these are potential witnesses. And we may want to be interviewing them and talking to them about what they saw, what happened. And it's possible, if this was in fact an attack, that the perpetrator is still nearby.
Sure. And can you walk us through when you were I want to say your title correctly,
as Deputy Commissioner of Counterterrorism of the New York City Police Department.
Thank you. Policies for this type of event. What's the first thing that police officers and fire department do in this event?
Life safety. Try to get people out of harm's way, get them to a hospital if they've been injured, secure the scene, begin the investigation, protect the responders against secondary attack.
And where are we in that process right now, would you imagine, in Boston?
It looks like a combination. They've begun life safety operations. You see ambulances there. They'll be taking people away. And they've begun to secure the scene, the lockdown of the Copley Hotel and the presence of police barricades.
And can you comment as to why there appear to be so few flashing lights? Certainly there are a lot of people in yellow, security personnel, but why there appear to be so few vehicles responding?
If this were NYPD, and I assume the Boston police respond with similar discipline, you don't want to charge the cars right in there because then it congests the area and you can't get in and out of it that easily. So they'll be held at an outer perimeter and then go in on foot. So that's, again, part of standard operating procedure. You create the inner perimeter,
right,
an outer perimeter, and you work your way in.